In our coming lecture number 2, topic is warm blooded and cold blooded animals. Okay, see, warm blooded animals and second is cold blooded animals. So, vertebrates may be warm-blooded or cold-blooded animals. The vertebrates animals means animals who have backbone. They can be warm-blooded also, and they can be cold-blooded animals. So, warm-blooded animals maintain a constant body temperature at all times, even if there is a change in the temperature of their surrounding also. So, like also we are also warm-blooded. Okay, human is also warm-blooded also. If any temperature change in our surrounding, we adapt it. So here also, so warm-blooded animals maintain a constant body temperature at all times if there is a change in the temperature of their surrounding also. If fish, in the if there is any change will be in their surrounding also, they will adapt. If there are cows also, whatever the mammals are there, reptiles are there, okay. They will adapt according to their surroundings. So these animals are called warm-blooded animals. So we are also warm-blooded. So and vertebrates can maybe warm-blooded also, can be maybe cold-blooded also. First thing what we know that, okay, so warm-blooded animals, they maintain a constant body temperature at all times, even if there is a change in their surrounding also. Okay, they will maintain that same temperature. We also maintain, if there is a change in our surrounding, temperature change, if there is also sometimes it's hot, sometimes it's cold, sometimes it's rainy, sometimes it's windy, then this we maintain that temperature. Now birds and mammals are warm blooded and animals. Okay, I told you vertebrates. Now birds and mammals comes in vertebrates animal. So vertebrates can be warm blooded also, vertebrates can be cold blooded animal. So in vertebrates, that birds and mammals, are what? Warm blooded animals. Now we move to cold blooded animals. So cold-blooded animals cannot regulate their body temperature and hence it changes according to the temperature of their surrounding. Like if you have seen a reptiles like salamander, lizard, they change their body color also according to the surrounding. Okay, because they cannot acquire that changes. So they cannot regulate their body temperature and they changes. Then they changes according to the temperature. That if you will see a lizard or salamander, they will change their color according to that temperature, according to the temperature and according to that surroundings. So cold-blooded animal means they cannot regulate, means maintain the body temperature, cannot regulate their what? Body temperature and hence it changes according to the temperature their surrounding. Okay, examples are there. Coral include fish, amphibian, and reptile. Fish, amphibians, amphibians and reptiles are cold-blooded animals. They are cold-blooded animals. Birds and mammals are warm-blooded animals. Understood? So now we move to next topic. Where animals live. So animals can live in terrestrial animal, terrestrial. Animals can live in animals. Okay, based on their habitat, animals can be divided into five groups. Terrestrial animal, aquatic animal, amphibians, aerial animal, and arboreal animal. So 101 we will see now. So based on their habitat, based on their habitat, animals can be divided into what? Five groups. So that groups are, I will tell you now that groups are terrestrial animals. Okay, the five groups are: first, terrestrial animals; second, aquatic animals; okay, and then third one, amphibian; fourth one is aerial animals; and five one is arboreal animal. Okay, so on the basis of the habitat, these are the five groups on which they can. Okay, so based on your habitat, animals can be divided into five groups: terrestrial, aquatic, amphibian. So animals who live in, animals who live on land, in deserts, and what? Very cold places. Animals who can live on land, in deserts, and very cold places. So examples like camels are there on land, in deserts, and very cold places. Or like these camels are there, some squirrels. So these are known as terrestrial animals. Now aquatic animals, animals who live in what? Water, like fish is there, dolphin is there, and turtle, etc. Amphibian, animals who can live in water and on land also. Examples are frogs. Okay, now aerial animals, animal who spends most of their time flying in air. Flying in air. So all the birds will come in this category. Okay. So instead of writing any particular, I will just write birds. And arboreal animal, animals who live mostly on tree. Animal who lives mostly on tree. Example, I just give you some monkeys are there, etc. So this is terrestrial, aquatic, amphibian, and avian. Now in next topic, I will go for that. What animals eat? Now they are eating habitat.